All right, it's the turn of the new year. You're ready for a change, for a fresh start. You want to feel good in your skin. You want to wake up every day and love your life. You want to chase after your dreams. You're ready to sit down and write out your goals and commit to your New Year's resolutions. But wait, before you do that, let's have a chat. Welcome. If you're new here, my name is Molly Mason. I'm a holistic nutritionist and I help women feel amazing in their bodies so they can show up for their brightest lives. If you're ready to stop fighting the war with your body, make sure you hit subscribe below for more tips. All right, we just gotta get right down to this. Research shows over 80% of New Year's resolutions fail by mid-February. Mid-February, friends. That's 12% in and you're already giving up. We all love this idea of waking up on January 1st and choosing to make our lives different, committing to a different kind of life. But the vast majority of us are epically failing on that endeavor. Let's just get real here. Most of us come to the end of the year and we reflect upon everything that happened. And oftentimes we focus on what isn't right and what didn't go well and what wasn't what we wanted it to be. Whatever it's looked like for you, I'd be willing to guess that you're sitting here at the end of 2021 reflecting on everything that did and didn't happen, and you're feeling this desire for change. You're feeling this desire for more. You know that you were made for more. But why is it when we have that and we have that urge and we have that itch to show up in a better, brighter, bigger way, why is it that so many of us give up 12% in? As a nutritionist, I am truly obsessed with the idea of habit change and change from the inside out. I cannot tell you how many thousands of times I've seen it where women are ready to show up, committed to a diet plan, a new lifestyle, a new exercise regimen. They are all in, they are ready to go, and then a few weeks in, they're done. They're done. They resent themselves. They resent their wellness journey because it's this constant swing of back and forth. It's this yo-yo of all this effort and all this failure. In all my research and all my work with women, I've discovered that there's two main reasons that New Year's resolutions do not work. The first is that they are not based in an identity change. I talked about this concept in a previous video, which you should definitely check out after this one if you want some encouragement in this area. This is what I've seen happen time and time and time and time again. We believe the change that we want in our lives is on the other side of accomplishing a certain level of achievement. So we sit here at the end of the year and reflect on what we want more of in our lives. We want more love, we want more affirmation, we want more confidence. We believe the lie that those things that we want, we will get once we achieve another level of being. And the truth of the matter is, that's backwards. You want to love yourself and feel confident in your skin, and you think that's going to happen once you lose weight. But the truth is, you're not going to lose weight and be healthy until you love yourself and choose to feel confident in your skin. You're not going to experience the body and health changes that you want until you believe that you are a healthy person who is worthy of health and all of the goodness that comes with that. I love the way James Clear describes this. He says there's three levels of habit change. The outside layer is outcome, the middle layer is habits, and the inside layer is identity. It's your beliefs. It's what you truly believe about who you are, about how you relate to the world, about what you're deserving of in it. New Year's resolutions fail all the time because we're not working on that identity piece. We're not getting clear on who we are, on what we truly want, why we want it. And we're not rewriting that identity and believing that we can have those things. I cannot tell you how often I see this with women that I work with. Even when we have everything we need to succeed, the thing that holds us back is that identity piece. It's that belief in who we are and what we are deserving of. The second reason New Year's resolutions fail is because we're so focused on that outcome, we neglect the process to getting there. A lot of people will tell you that they fail because the goals themselves are unrealistic or too big. I personally don't think that's the problem. I am of the belief that the sky's the limit, but we don't do a good job of truly breaking it down into the daily habits. Y'all, change does not happen overnight. Say it with me, change doesn't happen overnight. Achieving the goals you want doesn't just happen because you decide that you want them. It also doesn't just happen because you decide that you're worthy of them. You have to do the hard work of changing your life. And that comes down to changing your daily habits. A healthy body doesn't happen because you ate one salad. A healthy body doesn't happen because you did one really hard workout. A healthy body happens after committing day in and day out for weeks and months at a time to the tiny, small actions of health. We've all heard it said, nothing changes if nothing changes. This comes down to your daily habits. It has to be about your daily habits. So this year, instead of setting New Year's resolutions, I want you to do something different. I want you to commit to habit change, the kind that transforms your days and therefore your life, because y'all, your life is made up of your days. Maybe you do have a goal of losing 10 pounds. Maybe you do have a goal of running a half marathon. Those things don't happen overnight. You don't just decide that that's something you want and go achieve it in a day. You have to do the things on a daily basis that will get you there. You have to do the 10 weeks of training runs to get you to that half marathon. Okay, yes, maybe you could go out and try to run a half marathon right now, but that's not the wise thing to do. What you should do is commit to a training plan, to commit and show up every day, multiple times a week, commit to those runs, commit to those rest days, commit to that nutrition that will help you feel great. Y'all, the only thing you have is today. That's it, that's it. It's the only thing that you are currently in control of is what today looks like. This is the day that the Lord has made. This is the day that you have. When you make progress on the small things, when you commit to those tiny habits, you gain momentum. You change your identity. You go from an unhealthy person who doesn't care for their body, who doesn't eat well, who wants to run a half marathon, to a person who wakes up early and goes on runs and eats a nourishing breakfast and gets lots of sleep. That is a healthy person. Those actions make up a healthy person. It's the small things, it's the tiny things that add up, it's the daily habits. Those are the things that get you where you wanna go. So this year, instead of choosing big, crazy New Year's resolutions, I wanna encourage you to break that down. Commit to small habits. Think about the daily actions that are going to change your life. Think about that big resolution. Think about that end goal, that thing that you want. Think about the woman who has that thing. Think about the way that she wakes up every day and how she pursues her life and what her days look like. Break it down and commit to those small habits. If you want a tool to help you do this, I've got you covered. I've got my Star Chart Habit Tracker and Healthy Habits mini course. Y'all asked for this and I delivered for you. I shared with you in a previous video how I myself was feeling really overwhelmed in my own pursuit of health. I was getting so focused on wanting to overcome my diagnosis and find healing in my body and figure out the right steps to get there. And I was obsessing over the right supplements to take and the right protocol and all these things that were honestly making me lose track of the basic fundamentals and daily routines that helped me show up in my health. In an effort to bring myself back down to focusing on those daily habits, I created what I call my star chart. This truly transformed my life. It's simple, it's tangible, it's actionable, but it's also really rewarding and satisfying. I really believe an incredibly important part of the process is celebrating your tiny victories along the way, and the star chart itself is designed to help you do that, to celebrate those daily check marks, to celebrate those weekly stars. And y'all begged me for your own, so not only did I create tons of templates that you can customize for yourself, I also created a whole mini course to walk you through my four-step habit framework that will help you actually accomplish the change you want in your life. This is about making healthy habits stick. This is about transforming your days. This is about changing your identity. This is about change from the inside out. You get coaching videos from me, you get a workbook walking you through the process of casting your vision, choosing your habits, setting your goals, and committing to those things. And you get the fun part. You get this star chart template that you can customize, you can make your own, you can stick on your fridge, and you can use on a daily, weekly, monthly basis to help you make progress on your goals. I know you're gonna love it. It's going to transform your days and your weeks and your months and your year. I'll leave a link for you below to grab the star chart for yourself. I truly pray that it's the tool that's going to help you step into the 2022 of your dreams. I'm gonna be doing it with you guys. It's gonna be so much fun. Let's do it together. Let's show up for ourselves. Let's show up for our brightest lives this year. I love you. I'm cheering you on. I'm always rooting for you, and I cannot wait to see what this new year holds for you. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.